It kind of depends on who you're talking to, and a lot of it depends on who the cameraman is or the camerawoman, but mostly cameraman. Like on The Closer, for instance, I'm trying to remember how this got put, but it was a really difficult cameraman for the first several years, and they would joke about the fact that when Rick Wallace came in to direct, he just sort of held the reins on this cameraman very lightly. But when Elodie came in, she had him by a choke chain. And I was like, oh, is that? But I guess, yeah, because I was determined not to let him rule. And I was determined to get the shots that I wanted, to tell the story that I wanted, because he was only looking at the lighting and he was looking at ease of shooting, and it was all good. He was a genius, but I was looking at the storytelling. And for me, storytelling is the issue. So I would design shots that unfolded, that had dimension to them, where the story went from the front to the back or the back to the front, and he would want to be shooting over here. And I would like, well, you can do that if you want, but we're still going to shoot from here. I do have the one of the many things, blessings that I received from being an editor is I can see the shot. I know what the shot should be. I know where it should be. I never shoot material that doesn't go together. In fact, the downside of that is that I decided my film was boring at a certain point because I was so careful about making sure that it cut well that I didn't put the camera in an illogical place. I was constricted. So I started looking at the footage that other friends of director friends of mine were doing that was exciting to me and analyzing it and going, what are they doing? And why are they doing it? And sometimes they do it because they don't know anything. Sometimes they do it from lack of experience. They put the camera in a place that makes absolutely no sense because they just think they should put it there. Sometimes they do it on purpose. I like it when they know what they're doing, but I had to work on letting go, letting the reins go, and stop thinking about whether the editor was going to curse me out in the editing room, because I certainly had done that many times, you know. So that was really a learning experience, which is why I just love it when I get to a show that has a very specific thing they're doing. So like NYPD Blue, where it's like, oh, this is great. This is interesting, and I can use this in my arsenal at any time without anybody really knowing. Because, you know, you want to shoot the thing that you've planned, but you also wind in, you know, you run into time constraints, you run into all kinds of problems, and you wind up having to just get the thing shot in some way. If you've got tools that you've learned over the years that where you can put that right in there and you can get this thing done in 15 minutes, you're a hero. And I like doing that too. I like that. I will, yet another medical show, ill-fated medical show called Medical Investigations. They had a style where, I can't remember whether it was one or two guys, but there was this teeny little C camera operator. And so the deal was, and they wanted GAC, they wanted stuff in the foreground of all their shots. And so it was messy and it was out of focus, and there was the thing going on over there. And so they wanted you to set it all up, and then they wanted this little, physically little teeny guy to go and hide somewhere on the set and get another shot, get something else, as long as it didn't disrupt whatever it was you were shooting. Well, I would We would do that, and I would get the dailies, and I would invariably like what he did better. It was more interesting. It was more unconventional. I shot the straight shot, the stuff that they expect to see in dailies. You can't not shoot what I shot, but I was trying to figure out how I could abandon every plan that I ever made and just shoot that because it's better. So I just try to remember that. I try to get the non-conventional in and still tell the story in an interesting way. It's engaging.